Hello guys, welcome to my FL Studio tutorials. This is my first one. What? My name is Pollex and I am a very little known producer that just loves music but doesn't get appreciated enough for it. I'm so desperate that I literally listen to my own music more than anybody else to get money. Okay, enough about me. Tell me about yourself. I don't really care. Okay, so this is what you're going to see when you first... Oh, I'm sorry. This is what you're going to see when you first open up FL Studio. This is the basic template. Always you're going to look at it, this. What we are looking at right now is the channel rack. What is that? It's really important. Okay, a little bit about the channel rack. These are your sample sounds. They're just samples. They're not synths or anything. These are, I don't know what they're called, but they're like the little tempo. Each one of these symbolizes a quarter beat. Yeah. These are your mixer tracks. These target the corresponding track in your mixer. So if you go right here to your mixer, you'll see 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 103. Why they couldn't stop at 100, I have no idea. Oh, is that something? Okay, I have no idea. So yeah, right now you just got 1 through 4, because if you look right here, it's got 1, 2, 3, 4. Select them all. Just by clicking again. So if you like double, okay, don't click on any of them and then just like double click on one, it's going to have them all. Go to your mixer and then just right click on the first one and go to channel routing and route selected channels starting from this track. Or I found out the shortcut today, control shift L. Yeah, I found it out when I was recording this video the first time just to find out I didn't have any audio. But I messed around, and now I do, so that's cool. Yeah, so I never use these. So we're just, now that we have them all selected, just do Alt-Delete and delete them. And then this is always what you're going to have, just sampler. It's not anything important. Like, you could play all the notes you want, and nothing's going to happen. Oh, whoops, I forgot. I unplugged my MIDI keyboard. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, I have a little MIDI keyboard. It's literally like 2 octaves, but I love it. It's so cute. Okay, so actually, I don't remember how to do it. How do you do it? I know there's a way to do it. Oh, reset mapping. Okay. Boom. Now nothing's the same. Okay, so I always have this as one. Now, I'm always start with a basic synth, but I kind of figured out how to use them and I wish I'd known this first. So I'm just gonna let y'all know so you don't make the same mistake I did when I first did it. I would always just mess around with the samples and try to get them how I sounded with the synths. I'm sorry. I don't know why I'm apologizing to you. I don't even know you. I always just try to like mess around with them and get them to sound good, but they never really, I didn't know how to use them. So before you know how to use them, just go over here to plugin presets and go to generators. And I'm going to tell you, you can't choose all of these because some of them, unless you have the version of FL Studio where all the plugins are already in there, you don't have to buy any of them. There's only a set amount that are within this version. I have the producer version of FL Studio. I know they all come with the FL. Everything that starts Fruity or FL, I think all of these already are in here. I know 306, Drum Pad, Plucked, Citrus, and Wasp XT and Wasp are in here. I'm not 100% sure about the other ones, but if you're not sure, like this, it'll say demo version. That means it's not included and you're going to have to buy it to be able to use it to its full capabilities. It'll let you demo it and like preview it, see if you want like how it sounds before you buy it, but you won't be able to save it into your project. So I'm just going to do a simple little preset. Actually, I'm going to do Citrus and go to Chromatics and Percolator, which I found the other day, and I really like it. Okay, my MIDI keyboard is like, my computer's being slow right now, so 1 second and I'll be back. Okay, now I'm here. Okay, it takes a while to catch up because my computer is a little whatever, but I don't need my MIDI keyboard to be amazing. So, it is set at target mixer track 1. So, what we will do is go to our mixer, and since it's already selected, we can just do the first one, route selected channels to this track. Look at that. It's now got percolator selected to it. Okay, now over here is our slots where we insert different effects. I like reverb. So, you can already hear a big difference. Oh, one thing, don't even worry about this. I just figured out how to do it the other day. I'm just messing around. Honestly, I don't know how it works either, so better you than me. I'll go to Maximus and take out... Okay. Whoa, back up, Pollex. Where are you going? Okay, Maximus is really good for with the dynamics. If you don't want a really sharp, high-pitched sound, what you're going to do is go to the high-cut band and just kind of take it away. Just lower the pre- and post-gain volumes, and you don't get that much difference right now because it wasn't, I already took some of that away. But if you have like a really clicky, snappy sound, it's gonna kind of take it away and make it more soft and mellow. The mid is gonna be like, for like if you had a lead instrument, it's mostly in the mid band. It really just makes everything quieter. And then the low is if you want a good bass. You can hear it good right there. But I don't want... So, like, that's just a little something. I like it. I'm just going to create a really simple pattern. Always pattern one is the first pattern. I mean, that's obvious. It doesn't start at 0. It starts at 1. So, whenever you have this instrument selected and you're in pattern 1... You will click on this. This is your piano roll, and this is where you can put all your little different things. If you look, see when I do this, that note is selected. So I'm just messing around. Each one of these is going to be a quarter beat, and if you have your metronome on, that's really fast. So this is your tempo right here. You don't have to worry about all these. That's like the 10th, 100th, or 1,000th of a beat. Like, that's insanely exact. Who really cares about it being that exact? I know some people do. You do, you boo. I am not as smart as you. So I'm going to turn it down to like 115. No, too fast. I'm going to turn it down to 100. 100 is almost like my magic number. A lot of my songs are at 100, and I need to really branch out, but I just like 100. Okay, so the beat I use a lot is like it's like 3/4 beats to each beat, so it's gonna be like... But actually, I'm gonna extend that one. So yeah, and nice thing about FL Studio is wherever you stop, you can just like space to pause and play. It doesn't stop wherever it's left off. It stops where you last had it, which is really handy. I'm just trying to figure out which notes I needed. So yeah, that's just like a really simple little thing. I mean, it may seem complicated now, but before you know it, you'll be making really sick beats. Like, I don't know why I said that as if it sounds cool. Sick beats. Like, somebody give them some medicine. God. Okay. You see how short that is, though? Like, if you put this in here in your playlist, you'd have to repeat it over and over and over. Like, that does not make as much sense. I always try to have each of my patterns span 4 bars. Each one of these is a bar. I like trying to have my pattern span that much. So I'm just going to do Control A to select all, Control C to copy, Control V to paste. It's just like studying for a test. Copy, paste, like, or writing a paper, either one. Yeah, so now, look, it spans all 4. And that's enough time to give you enough variation without sounding too repetitive. So it's really, I really like copy pasting a lot. Yeah. Okay, pattern 2. We just scroll up, and now if you look in the piano roll, oh, look, it's empty. But we need to select a new instrument or instrument, synth, whatever you want to call it. But actually, usually, first I start with like a really simple synth sort of sound, but then I move right on to my drums. So most of your drum sounds are going to be under packs. You can import your own, but I mean, FL Studio has like, look, these are just some of the kicks. Just some of them. Like, I mean, yeah, they're not perfect. A lot of your first ones are going to be like really bassy sort of sounds. I like kick number 22, I think. So, since this is a percussion sound, you don't need to draw out the length of the note. You just need to have when it hits. Like, you can just use this for that. So the most common sort of percussion-y sound is just going to be on each single beat, like where the metronome is. So a really quick way to do that is you just right-click and fill each 4 steps. But see, it doesn't have it right here, so you just got to click right there and do it again. Yeah. But now we can just copy-paste it one more time so it fills up all the bars. And then we can put it right here. I usually try to separate my instrumental sounds from my drum sounds from my vocals. So I'll have like 3 main sections just to help me find what I'm looking for if I want to change something. It helps to keep it organized. A lot of people are a lot more organized than me. I just try. I try my best. I'm sorry. So now we listen. Okay, my metronome is still on. Now that I have a kick, I really don't need my metronome because the kick is like the foundation of the drums that keeps the beat. Like, if you didn't have a kick, sure, it might sound good still, but it doesn't have that foundation. Drums were originally just made to keep a beat. I mean, I don't know about that. I'm just making stuff up. But like, the primary function of drums in a song is to keep the beat. So if you don't have a drummer, it's really hard. You're more likely to get offbeat unless you're just amazing in your heads, all in sync. The drummer is like what's keeping it all together. So okay, I was just listening to it and I need a little variation in my first pattern, which is my instrumentals. I was just thinking, see, I have it 4 times. There we go. Okay, that's just a little bit better. Okay, now I need like a little snare, snap, clap, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to do actually a snap sample. So I'm going to go up to pattern 3. And my favorite snap sample is under legacy and drums and hip hop. And these are all built in, so you don't have to worry about, oh, where did you download this sample? Where did you do all this? Like, it's all within FL Studio. I imported one drum kit, and it was just free. An 808 drum kit I found. I don't know who did it. I would give you a shout out if I could. I like it. I use it for several of my songs. It's got really good bass kick sounds for like a hip hop beat. Well, that's the point. It's an 808. Anyway, so that's my snap sound. I'm going to have it on every second beat. So, boom. Well, you're not going to hear it yet until I put... Oh, gosh. Okay. I need to put it in here. Okay, you can't hear it all the way yet because I haven't... Well, you can hear it, but it's not exactly how I want it to sound because I have to put it in my... little thingy. So I always do reverb. I use reverb for almost everything except kicks. You don't want kicks or really bassy things to have a lot of reverb because it'll just make the whole song sound messy. You can definitely overdo reverb. You can also underdo it, but it's really easy to overdo reverb. So you just got to be careful that you don't overdo it. Let me see. Okay, and I'm going to add a chorus. You usually want to make sure you have your chorus sounds before your reverb because like it in your mixer, it's going to go from the first slot to the last slot and play all the effects in order. So it's not going to play them all at the same time. So you want to make sure that you have that in mind. I'm going to set all my depth, stereo, and delay up ahead to make it sound more distant. I'm going to have my delay all the way up. See, that sounds good. Okay, if you look at this, see, this is the right and the left channels, or the left and the right, sorry, and how it's not even, because I have such a quick sound. The percolator is meant to go like back and forth between channels, so I've got to help it out a little bit. And just like you got to earball it. You got to hear it. I mean, just because it looks right on paper does not mean it sounds right. The most important thing to keep in mind is there's not a formula for music. There's no way you can computer generate it. Some people say that producers nowadays, they don't really do anything. The music just makes itself. Well, I mean, to a certain extent, music does make itself, but like you are the one making it. You can't just have a program that, oh, it makes beats and you can just put your name on it. Like, no, that's not how it works. There's a lot of work that goes into it. And I feel like people don't understand that as much. Okay, soapbox over. Bye, guys. This is just a really basic. This is like what I always start my songs off as. Oh, let me show you what I'm doing. Okay, double click on a channel and that selects all of them. And then you can right click. I already showed you all this, but I'll show you again. And select channels routing from this track. I mean, it's already routed, just it helps show you what's going on. If you like turn your little head sideways, you can read it. And it tells you what samples or what synths or whatever is routed to that insert. So yeah, this is just a really basic first time tutorial. I'm sure y'all have lots of questions. Comment down below like any questions you would have, and I'll try my best to answer them in future videos. I know I probably left a lot of loose ends. I'm going to try to tie up my best in some future videos. Just please let me know, and anything you want to see in a tutorial video, let me know that as well. And it'd be amazing if you subscribe for more videos. I'm going to try to post as much as I can. No promises. I'm sorry. And like my video, share it with your friends. That'd be great. Thank you so much for watching. It really means a lot, like, for real. Okay, I will see y'all guys later. Thank you so much for watching again. Goodbye.